He's awesome. He's awesome. Come on, come on. Let's keep praising him. Yeah. Come on, let's just keep giving glory to him. Come on, we're going to tap in today. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. He's awesome. What a mighty God we serve. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Take us higher, Lord. Take us behind the veil, God. We take that stronghold, Father. In the name of Jesus. We can find it all.
Break every chain.
Amen. Stand to your feet. Amen. Give God some glory. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Everybody stand to your feet if you can. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. At this time, I present to you the man of God of this house, the founder, the man who God chose, Dr. Ricky L. Barnett. Amen. Give us the man of God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
There is nothing like the presence of the Lord. And as we seek His face, He is hearing this praise. There is nothing like the presence of the Lord. Come, the reward of worship is God. All I want is you.
Let's worship Him.
You are my reward. You are my reward.
I'll touch you with your
heart. All I want. So yes, you can be healed in the presence of God, but He is the reward of worship.
All I want.
He is the prize. All I want. Thank you.
stand right like this. I need some intercessors. I need some worshipers up in this house. I need some worshipers up in this house. Come on, somebody.
Let your weight so come we can barely breathe. Your glory.
Oh, how do I too, but
your glory. All I want.
I need somebody to worship God. I need some intercessors.
The person.
Oh. Do I have any intercessors in the house?
Take me.
I need that door closed, please. Look at the movie.
need to spend, they need a prayer, you can come now. You might say they need a prayer. His presence is here. Come down. Make it quick. Not that much time. Not that much time. Those who need prayer need to come where the Spirit is moving. Keep it going. I need some worship, not no churchy. I don't need no churchy. I need some Grace William. I need some Grace Williams, please. Take me in the spirit. I need some Grace Williams, please. Oh, shout out. Put your hands up. I need Grace Williams, please. Oh, shit, that about something. I break the power of the enemy. In the name of Jesus, I come against every principality, every power, every ruler of darkness that's hindering your finances, your position, the vision and purpose. We break power of the enemy against you right now. In the name of Jesus. Shere bokos, take it. Oh, surrendese. Raise your hands up. Oh, shere alabas. I can read. Now raise your head up. Bless him, man, conversations in the house. The Spirit of God is here. Spirit comes, you want honor, you want reverence. People need to be healed. People are hurting. Jesus. Bless him now. Bless him now.
I can feel you're anointing.
Open up every door.
You're anointing. Sets me free. You're anointing. Yeah.
Take this gift.
Yes, I can
feel. Take this gift. Unravel it, Father.
Touches me, your anointing sets me free.
I pray healing.
Yeah, yeah.
He's here. Raise your hands up.
Yeah.
Raise your hands up.
Yeah.
Everybody raise their hands up. The presence is here now. He's here.
Yeah.
He's a blessing.
Yeah, yeah.
Your presence is here. Your presence is here. Oh, Shaddai, oh, say, there's a fire going to be released upon you. Dynamite comes in small packages. That's a fire that's going to be released upon your life. It's going to confound people. In being contacted, there's pain. Yeah, it ain't both up. When something's being compacted, to be powerful, there's pain. If you can endure the pain, you shall have the power. If you can endure the pain, I say, if you can endure the pain, then you will have the power to heal, to deliver, to break chains and fetters, to speak a word and it shall come to pass. If you can endure the pain, if you can endure the pain, you shall have the power. If you can endure the pain, you shall have the power. God is molding you. God is shaping you. God is compacting you. Watch God. He gonna light it on your heart, and they gonna see you burn. People gonna see you burn. People gonna see the fire of the Baruch HaKadosh upon your life, upon your ministry. You gonna see it. You gonna see it. Yes, if you can endure the pain, you shall have the power. If you can endure the pain, you shall have the power. If you can endure the pain, you shall have the power. Woo! Thank you, Jesus. I command everything, every organ in your body to be healed. God, I command it. I don't ask that. I command it. Rando sere kato kanehe. Be healed by his blood and by his stripes. He's here. He's here. He's here. He's come to bless his children. He's here. He want to bless his children. He want to bless his children. He want to heal, deliver, set free, open up doors, close doors. A lot of you been hurt since y'all were little, you boy, girl. A lot of y'all still have the wound from your past. Something happened with your little boy, little girl. You've been keeping it secret. You've been keeping it secret because of the spirit of shame. Release it to Jesus. Release it to Jesus. Release it. Put it in his hands. Release it. Release it. Some of y'all been hurt when y'all little kids. Y'all been keeping it secret. No one knows about it. You don't tell nobody about it. That very thing, if you don't get put it in Jesus' hand, will destroy you. Cause cancer in your body. Tumors. Something happened when you was a little young, real young. And you had a spirit of shame. You didn't want to tell nobody. You said to keep it a secret. You think it'll go away, but it had not gone away. Shout out my coast. Okay? If you don't let that thing go, put it in the hands of Christ. Say it out by side. Put it in Christ's hands. Put it in his hands. He has the power. Destroy that thing. He can destroy it.
Set me free.
Let it go.
Hallelujah.
Let it go. Let it go today. Let it go.
Hallelujah.
Let all that hurt go. Let all that shame. Somebody give a spirit of shame. Spirit of shame. Somebody give a spirit of shame. Spirit of shame. Ah, my hashtag. Spirit of shame. Somebody deal with the spirit of shame. Spirit of shame. We come against it right now. We come against it right now in the name of Jesus. Come against the spirit of shame right now. It was not your fault. 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 Yeah, that I my soul for the hasty. It was not your fault. Yeah, the house of the spirit of shame. I come against you. I break your power. I break your power. I break your power. I break your power. I break your power over the children of God. I break your power. Yeah, I know for the spirit of shame. I break your power. Sora boko sekere santa. I curse you at the root. I take authority over you in the name of Yahshua. I take the sword of the Spirit with the Lord righteous. Cut the cord of the wicked. I disconnect you right now. Shame, I come against you right now. In the name of Yahshua. Spirit of shame. Spirit of shame. I'm so glad to hear what happened. Come here. God is going to do something great to me. You're going to do something great. That prayer has been answered. It's been praying for 8 years. I need all the other prayers. Yes. You're going to see with your own eyes how much God loves you. You're going to see with your own eyes how much God appreciates you worshiping Him. God, you're going to see with your own eyes all the sacrifice you have made, all the tears that you have shed. All the pain that you have endured. All the pain that you have endured. Yeah. This year, he's going to take it all away. He's going to go. You're going to step into who you are. You're going to step into who you are. And this child shall be a blessing. This is a special child. This is a special child. This child will have gifts your other children will not have. This is a promise. It should have gifts that's so profound. Prophetic gifts. Oh, they say they can. Oh, Shadone. Yeah, they buranda rarabakese. All will come upon this child. The blessings have been held back. Shall come upon this. I decree it. I decree it. You shall not lose it. Shall not lose it. Lord, strengthen the move. Strengthen the move, Father. And close the sea. Divine protection. Come against any demonic force, any principality, power that come against the sea. Oh, Shadabah, I come against you. I break your power. Yeah, I take the sword of the Spirit of the Lord and righteous. Cut the cord of the wicked enemy. They said, right more in the head. Lord, release the blood. The blood in there. The blood of Yahshua. Up on her right now. Divine protection. Divine, Father. Let this be divine, Father. Release your angels. Hey, they go, Saka. Nothing. Just stop and work in the Word of God in your life. Nothing. Just stop the work in the Word of God in your life. I say, nothing shall stop. The promises of God shall come to pass. That you have seen, that He has promised you, you shall surely see it come to pass in your lifetime. Because of you sold out. It's what you persevered. Knowing all the pain you go through, the pain you went through to serve God. The heartache, the shame, the disappointment, and the discouragement. But God knows. Because of that, you shall have your reward. There's crowns. You're going to have many a crowns. There's many a crowns. Not one. You're going to have multiple crowns in heaven. Oh, shit. People don't know. But God knows. God sees. God sees everything. He sits high and He looks low. Oh, shit. You're going to be a blessed. And you shall be a blessing. You have the right heart. The right heart for His people. The right heart for His people. The right heart for His people. Because of your heart. Because of your heart is right with God. People don't understand you. You've been misunderstood. But God saw your heart. God saw your heart. God saw your heart. God saw your heart. And it was your heart that turned His head towards you. It was your heart that turned His head your way. There's a blessing upon your life. There's a blessing in your hand. There's a favor of God upon you. It'll be a testimony. A testimony. A sacrifice. Bless. He's blessing you today. He's blessing you today. Blessing you. Watch when we go to Africa. Watch when we go to Africa. You will find yourself. You will find yourself. You will find yourself. No more wondering. The whole question, He will show you. Woo, Lord have mercy. Let's worship Him. Let's worship Him. He's here. Holy, holy, holy. He's holy. Your purpose. We're gonna turn your pain to power. We're gonna turn your pain to power. We're gonna turn your pain to power. Because you have endured a lot of pain. People don't understand what you endured. But the Lord was there. The Lord knows all. What the devil meant for evil, because of who and what he has predestined for you. You shall be blessed. You shall be blessed. You shall have that he promised you. The devil could have killed you. But God said no. Death, back up. He has a plan. Shall come. It's coming. Total emotional healing shall come. You're going to be able to look back and testify and give God the glory. Because out of that pain shall come power. From power to purpose. Out of the very thing the devil tried to destroy you.
The atmosphere of heaven is touching you right now. The atmosphere of heaven is healing you right now.
It's healing you right now.
Touching you, changing you, making more.
There's ministry, the work that was done Saturday is a beginning
of
something,
lift your hands
and I'm going to be involved in it. This ministry is going to be involved with it. Raise your hands up. Feeding the hungry,
closing
the depths, the
atmosphere of heaven.
That's the work of Christ.
Healing you right now.
I'm asking the Lord to bless the finances in the ministry.
Meet every need. Things new, it's fresh, flowing from heaven. It's fresh.
Blessings shall come. I speak over the ministry of having the homeless, feeding the homeless, clothing the homeless. Lord, multiply all the resources. Because they have a desire to give more, to feed more. Father, increase support. Increase support, Father. Increase financial, material support. Let them receive from corporations, Father. Walmart, Kmart, Shedablecar, all those stores that have grants to give. Father, I ask you to formalize, to materialize this feeding of the homeless and clothing the homeless. You give them desire for those who are downtrodden. Lord, because of the heart you're giving them for those who are helpless, I ask you to bless them in their lives, individually and collectively, Father. Bless them in their lives. Prosper them, Father, because they have the heart to give. So bless them, make them, Father, distribution centers, that they will distribute. They will distribute into the kingdom, Father. So I ask you to release finances, release resources in their hands, Father, for your kingdom's sake. Worship him. He's fresh oil. It's flowing to you right now. It's flowing to you right now. It's flowing to you. You guys have been blessed in this house today. The devil tried to aggravate me in my spirit. Things out of place, things out of order. But I know how to get myself out of the way. And that's the secret to ministry. How to move yourself out of God's way and become a vessel for God. It's a gift. It's a gift. Because he had me in the flesh, the devil. Learn, it can be done. We have to learn how to move ourselves out of the way. When we get ourselves, God works through us. It's something I want to teach those who want to be used by God. How to move yourself out of the way. Because yourself will become your enemy. Yourself will be fighting against yourself. And fighting against the spirit. How to move self out of the way. Let the living God work through you. Work through you. The devil don't want him to work through you. The devil don't want him to work through you. That's why you go through what you go through, the attacks you have. Because he don't want you to be used by God. The devil can keep you in the flesh, you never can step into the spirit. So his job is to keep you in the flesh. Because the carnal mind is enemy against God. It fights against the spirit. You are special vessels because what you have been going, you have gone through, and what you are going through. That's who you are. That's why you go through what you have gone through and going through, because of who you are. The devil don't want you to know who you are. You are children of God. Children of God. Children of God. And I want to bless you today and encourage you today that you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. Notice I said through Christ. It's in him. You move, breathe, and have your being. It's in him. It's all him. It's not you. It's not about you. It's about him. It's all about him. Devil had me so vexated when I came in here, everything about our water. He knows how to get me. I have a spirit of excellence. And sometimes the spirit of excellence can fight it. He can use a weapon against you when things are out of order. You understand me? The devil can use that that God has blessed you with as an attribute. He can make it a deficit if you know how to handle it. The spirit of excellence was fighting against me today. Because things were not in order. Things were wrong. And all I had to do, I know how to get myself. And that was you have learned how to do, how to get yourself out of the way, because you've been your own problem. I'm flowing in the Spirit. I got a word for you today, too. Can I flow in the Spirit for 5 minutes and minister to somebody up in this house? Many of you wonder why you haven't received that you've been asking God. It's you. God's waiting on you. God's waiting on you. You. Wherever you come to, God's waiting on you. We waiting on God, but God waiting on you. God's outside of time. We the one in time. And the spiritual realm supersedes the natural realm. God got all, you got eternity, do you have eternity in this body? No, you're limited in time, distance, and space. So you must come in agreement with the word of God and the will of God and the spirit of God in your life. You come in agreement, we can line up. Your spirit first, soul second, and your body lines up. That's the original order. In the Garden of Eden, it was the spirit, soul, body. After the fall, it was the body, soul, spirit. Spirit and the body. Jesus came. Now, the choice is you. But to let the spirit be in control over your soul or your body, the choice of yours is to let that mind be in you. It was also in Christ. You have to let it. He's inside you. And who's going to be in charge today? You or him? When I came in here, I was in charge. But I was in the flesh. I keep it real. But I know how to get the spirit. Oh, and it's you have to have humility in the spirit, true humility, not false humility. People can act humble, but they're not humble. They can put on the facade of being humble, but they're not humble. They are being phony, pretending to be humble. But the spirit knows if you're humble, because he will supersede, he'll step up. But he knows that you have a true humble spirit. See, people think he's trying to play God with all this phoniness. Amen? The Lord knows everything. He knows. So come keep it real with God. If you ain't there yet, don't fake it till you make it. Amen? Keep it real with it. He knows anyway. Stop trying to be phony, like you're humble, you're still prideful. Because you're gonna have a test to see. They test you. Meekness. Meekness and humility is the key to open up the spiritual realm and the use of his power. Without meekness, which is controlled strength, he will not allow you to have power unless you're meek. Because you can abuse the power if you're not meek. You can misuse the power, hurt people with the power. Just be more meek, seek more meekness, you want more power. God is not going to release power, spiritual power on some folk. Because he still sees pride in it. Amen. Pride will stop you from receiving the power. And being humble, you have to go through some things that will humble you. If you let God have his work, let him complete his work. Stop fighting it to come to it. Once you bottom out, he'll build you up. Some folks don't want to bottom out. Total surrender. Total submission. Enough of that. I got a word for you. Good Lord, I have prayed. Is anybody blessed today? Y'all allow me to flow the spirit like this without trying to make me be religious. You will grow. The ministry. You will accelerate tremendously in the spirit. That anointing upon you will supersede the average anointing in any church. It will supersede the average anointing most pastors. You'd be a lay person. Let's give the Lord a hand, praise. I got a word for you. I want to thank you. And I want to ask the ministry, let's take it to the next level in professionalism. I want to get more involved and know what's going on. When I get here Sunday, I want to know what I'm facing if I walk through the door. So I got to get better communications. I want to know everything. Because I can't, the devil catch me off guard. I'm expecting one thing and seeing another. So I want to know on Sunday what's happening, what the program is, who's doing what. So I'll be aware of my spirit. My spirit is very sensitive. When things are out of place, when people are out of position, when people not here, should be here, my spirit is very sensitive to it. And I don't want to be caught off guard. Because it can cause fixation of spirit. When they have fixation of spirit, it can cause something else to happen. And people cannot get blessed. Because I know how to surrender to the spirit. How to submit to the spirit. Then it won't hinder the blessing. But a lot of people don't know how to do that. It's a gift from God. It's a grace. And you receive that grace through tests, through trials. Tests and trials and tribulation, how you count the things God take you through to make you. Give the Lord a hand, praise. Won't we be here tonight? We have a service tonight. We're back here at 6:30. Amen. Be a musician, all the leaders like to see you support this tonight. You be blessed. I bring this man of God here for you. Edify the ministers of this house tonight. So I want the minister of support. You're going to hear some things tonight. Going to take the next family dimension tonight. It's the only man they allowed to teach at USC Deliverance. Amen? The only man they allowed to teach Deliverance at USC. Amen? So he must be profound in that arena. Amen. So give the Lord a hand, praise. Praise the Lord, time down.
Sword of the Spirit Power Ministries with Bishop Ricky L. Barnett.
Let's give the Lord a hand, praise. Let's give the Lord a hand, praise over the past again. Amen. Oh my God. Let's give the Lord another hand, praise. Amen. Let's give you a hand, praise. Truly an honor to be before you today. I'm still flowing in the spirit, giving reverence to God, and getting my life, giving honor to the first lady, give her a hand, praise. All the ministers on the watching, the man, praise, amen. All the ministers in the house, all the teachers, all those, the leadership, and all of God's children, and those watching us by internet, we truly thank you for being here. The presence of God is at his house, and his tangible anointing is here. Amen. What I was given to give you is out of 2 Corinthians. Really be in the 10th chapter. And I'm not going to go through too many verses. Verse 6 due to time. Amen. This is Paul's second epistle to the Corinthian church. Amen. And in this particular letter, or in this particular part of this epistle or letter, Paul started dealing with the authority of Paul's ministry, his authority. See, in the first 9 chapters, he is writing to the majority of the congregation who loved and appreciated him, okay? In the remaining chapter, he turned his attention to the small pocket of resistance which continued to voice opposition to his ministry. See, apparently there were former Jews professing faith in Christ, but who were actually false apostles. Since the apostle is now certain that the majority of the believers are with him, he is emboldened to deal more forcefully and directly with this group of resistance, which is among him. And so he will defend his apostleship. And we find that in verse 10 through chapter 10, 1 through 18, but I'm not going through all of it. I'm only going to do so many verses today, maybe later on. And he will boast of his experience later on in another chapter, and he would demonstrate his credentials later on. And then he would charge him to repentance later on in this chapter. But today we're going to deal with probably no more than 7 verses of chapter 10. Chapter 10, Paul's epistle. The word of God says, "Now, I, Paul, myself, beseech you by the meekness and gentleness of Christ, who in presence am base among you, but being absent and bold towards you." Paul is saying, "Myself beseech you by the meekness and gentleness." Meekness is not weakness. Being meek is not being weak. Say, being meek is not weak. The problem with a lot of folks, when they deal with meek people, they think they are weak people. But really, meekness is controlled strength, controlled power. So God will not allow you to have power unless you're meek. If you're not meek, he wouldn't allow you to have the power, because you can misuse the power because you don't know how to control the power. Meekness causes you to control the power. See, prideful people cannot have power because they would destroy God's people. Because meekness and pride contradicts itself. He can have intellectual power. Amen? They can operate from man's reasoning and intellectualism. When you start dealing with spiritual power, then meekness has to be there. Because that power, like a two-edged sword, it can cut both ways. Oh, you don't hear me now. If you don't have meekness, you can destroy folks with power, spiritual power. Paul said, I deceive. Then he said, Paul, myself beseech you by the meekness, my control of power, and gentleness of Christ, who in presence am base among you, or low among you, but being absent and bold towards you. I'm not there with you now, I'm bold towards you. Now, Paul was speaking to a specific group of resistance of people in the church of Corinth. Most of the congregation was with him, but there was a small pocket of resistance that challenged his authority. Is it something when God raised a person up, okay, what they do, obeying the will of God, he always will have resistance. Always have a small group of folk that are always resisting their authority. And Paul was confronted as an apostle with a small pocket of these Jews. They said they accepted Christ, but they were false. And in any situation, circumstance, any man of God who operates, who demonstrates the anointing and the power of God and operating the glory, will have a pocket of resistance. You know, majority of people, but you know, and that's expected. It comes along with the position. It comes along with the territory. So Paul was dealing with this. And he was dealing, and he started being bold. He's ready to put himself in the position of war. Okay, you want to resist me? You want to resist my authority? You want to come against my position? Okay, do you truly want to fight with me? That's why Paul said, I came in meekness. I come in gentleness in Christ. I have the power to do something to you. But because the meekness of Christ in me, my gentleness, I'm going to come boldly, but I'm going to control what God has given me, the arsenal that he has given me, the weaponry he has given me, in the spirit realm, I'm going to approach you in meekness and gentleness. But if I come to you, other than that, I can destroy you because of the spiritual power that God had allowed me or given to me by grace. Some of you shouldn't mess with. Some folks best to leave alone. Now, Paul was one of those. That's why he said, I come to you in meekness and gentleness, but I'm going to deal with you in boldness. I'm going to confront you. I know you're against me, yet you're among me. But you are causing problems with those that with me. So I got to confront you. Then he went over and says, I make a point. See, the apostle not only understands that his authority comes from Christ, but even the accompanying grace with which that authority is exercised. There's an unmerited favor, there's a grace. See, the power, the authority comes from Christ. See, Christ gave Paul that power. Amen? But he gave him a grace to go along with it. Amen. Verse 2. But I beseech you that I may not be bold when I am present with that confidence wherewith I think to be bold against some, which think of us as if we walked according to the flesh. But I beseech you that I may not be bold when I am present with that confidence wherewith I think to be bold against some, which think of us as if we walked according to the flesh. See, those people was dealing with Paul like he was just a regular man in the flesh. They might have seen, you know, his human side. And he was judging everything but that natural side, the human side of him. And they could not really understand the spiritual side. Who was behind Paul? Who had given Paul that spiritual power? See, the carnal mind cannot perceive the things of the spirit. Mm-hmm. See, some folk only gonna see people from the flesh. And they wait to see a flaw of them in the flesh. Then when they see them in the flesh as a human, They ain't nothing, they ain't no apostle, they ain't this, they ain't that. But they forgot that that power is through the grace of Christ. An unmerited favor, something that was allowed upon them from Christ. Now he's the one who appointed, anointed, and ordained and empowered. What they're doing, there was something they come against a vessel, they actually come in against God. They think they come in against a man, but they come and guess who's behind that man. Like, I'm God, I know who I, you telling me I chose the wrong one? People don't know what they're dealing with sometimes. They do stuff and they forget one thing, God, who says high and looks low. Amen? Yeah, put their mouth on. God said, wait a minute here. You calling me a fool? That I chose the wrong one? I think your arms are too short to box with me. People don't know what they're doing. They coming against vessels of God, men of God, women of God, because they see, they think they're giving them in the natural, but they forgot who's behind them in the spirit. Then they wonder why everything going wrong in their life. See, these are player haters. Amen?
Amen.
These false apostles. These Jews. Amen? Amen. They know Paul, you know. And they come in resisting, whispering, saying things behind his back. Amen? They don't think God is omniscient. He's all-knowing. He's omnipresent. He's everywhere at the same time. He's omnipotent. He's all powerful. That God don't know what you're saying. You whisper in secret. But God's omnipresent. He's there listening. Then you go to God. Lord, do this for me. Lord, do this. Wait a minute. I heard you over here coming against someone that I chose, and you want me to do what for you? Oh, people forget. They forget about God. They're taking him out of the equation and dealing with God's vessels. He said, but I beseech you that I may not be bold. Please, Paul already said, please do not force me to prove this allegation to be false. Now, please don't force me. Don't force me to prove that your allegation against me is false. Don't force me. Don't force me. Paul said, don't force me to prove the allegation you spoke against me is false. See, the word says, some which think of us as if we walked according to flesh. See, the charge is not that he is carnal, but that he is lacking divine unction in his ministry. They were saying that by Paul. And he usurped the apostolic office to himself. They were saying that, they said the charge is not that he is carnal, but that he is lacking divine unction in his ministry and has usurped the apostolic office to himself. That's what those Jews were saying about Paul. They said, yeah, you're not carnal, maybe spiritual. But God is not leading him in his office. He's doing that to himself. And Paul was saying, don't you force me. I beseech you, don't you force me. Amen?
Amen.
He said, for though we walk in the flesh, Paul's reply was, we walk in the flesh, that is, we are just human beings. But we do not war after the flesh. To paraphrase it, you see me as a person, and perhaps that is not convincing. But if you walk with me a while and see what my work requires me to do, then you will be convinced. You walk in my shoes, you walk with me a little while, then you be convinced that I am who I say I am in Christ. Because Christ, Paul was bold with who he was in Christ. And they thought he was carnal. Now he wasn't carnal, but that the Holy Spirit, the divine unction was not behind him. He was doing it all to himself because of his boldness. But Paul said, you just walk with me. When you see what I do, then you will be convinced. Sometimes folks need to know every little detailed thing about everything. Hey, you mess with folks that think they know everything but don't know nothing. You can't tell them nothing. They already know the answer to this. They already know the answer to that. They already got it up on everybody. They all powerful. They all knowing. They like God. They know everything. Any subject you bring up, I know how to do that. And then, oh, I can do that. Watch those folks. Watch folks like that. They are dangerous not only to people, but they're dangerous to themselves. That's an exalted spirit. That's a prideful spirit. That's an unteachable spirit. That's a spirit of lack meekness, which is also, it is making them teachable. So nothing, they never can be taught anything because they know everything. They're already there. They already have arrived. They're already sitting upon the throne over God. So they done hooked up with the wrong kind of spirit, not knowing they hooked up with Satan. That's the attitude of Satan. Oh my God, I want to be like the Most High God. Be very, very careful. Be very, very careful. Be very, very careful. This is the warning. The Lord gave me this morning. This is the warning. This is the warning. Paul was confronted with this resistance. He said, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. He said that Paul did not possess divine authority, he could not possess divine power. See, when you operate in divine power, that means you're operating in divine authority. When you operate in divine authority, that's delegated authority from the divine that delegated that authority to that vessel. Same thing. You start coming against the police officer. He got delegated authority. He got a license to kill. Correct? Now, you're dealing with him, You not only deal with him, you just dealing with who's behind him. Uh-huh. He's just a representative of the true power, that government or that metropolitan that gave him that authority. They come against the police, but yet they don't know they're coming against what's behind the police. So when you come against a vessel of God, then you're actually coming against who's behind them. And that's the mistake they make. Out of ignorance, they don't know. That was my people that struggle with lack of knowledge. They come against God. Oh, you don't hear me. You don't hear me. We got to be very careful. Very careful. We want God to bless us. We want God to bless God on these prayers for breakthrough and all. Lord, give me the. But you haven't received it. Why you haven't received it? Maybe you're making that one little mistake. Small foxes swallow the vine. And these little small things like that could be a hindrance. Man look on the outer, but God look on the heart. God look in the heart of man. Is your heart right with God? Is your heart right with God? Is your heart right with God? I always had a thing about my heart being right. Even when I was in the world, I had a thing about my heart being right with God. I'm not gonna treat people wrong. Love folk, help folk, do good to people. You know, that's been my nature since I had an encounter with a boy, the spirit came in me. Before then, I was a devil. I know I was a straight devil, so I knew how it was. I was a devil like a little boy. I knew that whole carnal thing, how to be jealous, mischievous, all the envious and all that kind of stuff. But when I write my book, I bring all that out. I had an encounter at 7 years old that changed my life internally, but not outwardly, but inside. The spirit was inside of me that made me treat people right. Although I did wrong, but I didn't do wrong. I didn't mistreat people. I always help people. I've been doing this since I was a little boy. Always treating God's people right. This people right. This people right. Still be doing wrong in the flesh, but still treat people. Don't hurt people. Try to help people. That been my nature since I had an encounter as a little boy and a death experience. So my thing was, long my spirit was always at peace inside when I lay down and go to sleep. And whatever was inside me was at peace. I was all right. I didn't know what it was. But I knew the difference how it was before I had that encounter. Yes. The Lord told me to give that brand new car away. I wasn't even in church. He tested my heart to see if I would obey. They told me to give the car away, I gave it away. He attached your heart with his people. You understand that? He never even trust you. So he'll trust you. He'll trust you. If you be faithful over a few things, I'm going to be ruler over much. I'm telling you now, I'm boasting in the Lord. I know who I am in Christ. But I had to pay the price for that. I done passed the test through over 58 years of treating people basically the same way. 57 years. Like, through the Spirit. He would test you all the time. Is your heart right? And I'm talking to somebody maybe out there. You asking God to do something for you, but is your heart really right towards God? Or your head think you're right towards God? But is your heart, your spirit, really right towards God. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. But Paul's strength was mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. Paul, as an apostle, was mighty through God for pulling down strongholds. That was spiritual power and spiritual authority through the grace of Christ that was given to Paul, that he had the power of the grace to pull down strongholds in people's lives. See, that's spiritual authority and spiritual power. If you want that kind of power, that type of authority, get your heart right with God. When you get your heart right with God, then you're going to start walking in true humility, not in false humility. Mm-hmm. You're walking true humility. Not exalting yourself, but in a lowness of spirit. Be willing to do things that people in the position you're in, people, why are you doing that? Why are you doing that? I mean, when I came to Arizona, I mean, with the Arizona, my spiritual son from Africa came, stayed with us a couple of days, and he was one of my guests. He came in the kitchen, and here I am cooking breakfast with everybody. He was shocked, because in their culture, they see a person in position as a king. Kings don't do nothing. Just tell people what to do. He saw me as a servant. I'm cooking the breakfast. He said, Apostle, what are you doing? He was shocked. It blew him away, because they never seen a person with a title or authority in servitude. I said, I'm cooking breakfast. In our country, men of God don't do nothing. They just get served. He was shocked. It's a culture shock. But humility, you humble, it's natural to be a servant. See, God wants servant leaders. He wants you to be a servant leader. If I want to be a servant, people serve me. I don't like to deal with folk. I always want to be served. I have some, you know, some people in the ministry. Oh, you can. They can't carry their bag. They can't do nothing. They won't. They step up there like a big old king or queen. A lot of women like queen and she was servant. I can't stand that mess. Seriously, I'll get down with y'all. I clean the toilets. I put down the trash. I'll mop the floor. I run back in that booth and play the music. Mm-hmm. Amen. Run back up there and preach.
Amen.
Reverend Ross, when I do it, he see me do it. I done it all. I done it before. I'm a servant first. I'm lowly in spirit. And Paul was lowly in spirit. To be true, for God to use you, you got to be low in spirit. You want to be exalted up? Huh? You're going to have true God's spiritual power. You might have a power, but it might not be God's power operating. Oh, you don't hear me now. Some folks will operate some power. Amen. But it's not God's power. I came in a place where man operated some power. I didn't feel the presence of God up in that house. I seen them operating in some power. I didn't feel God's presence. God was nowhere in that place. Just a man operating. And his gift. Amen. He says, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty to God to put it down with strongholds. Strongholds. Then casting down imaginations. Now, imaginations. Imagination is part of the soulish realm. It's mind, will, emotion, intellect, and there's the imagination. The imagination part of the soulish realm that the devil can get in and start playing tricks with you through your imagination. Like you start seeing stuff in your imaginations like a movie, and you think it's God. But your imagination's been tapped into. The devil can open you up. And you start seeing some stuff that's not from God in your imagination. And Lord, tell me to tell you something. Don't believe everything that somebody tell you about somebody else.
Amen.
Don't believe. Like at the Super Bowl party, somebody started talking about Beyonce. Beyonce, the soulless. I said, I don't believe that. Oh, we saw it on the internet. Her doing all this time. Don't you know the internet, somebody going to the internet, there's haters. You put a lie or photo shoot something about somebody that's an enemy of that particular person. And here you going around perpetrating a lie because you ain't got the proof to ask, you ain't got to connect with Beyonce to ask her directly, do you sell your soul to the devil? And you going around perpetrating a lie because you done seen this there, that'll mean everything on the internet is not true. You gotta discern the spirit. You gotta have discernment of spirit. My spirit didn't bear witness with it. My spirit didn't bear witness with it. My head can't even get it, but my spirit said, no, don't be trying to believe that. So, we had to learn, don't be used by the devil. That the devil used us to perpetrate lies about somebody. I remember when I was growing up, when James Brown got big and famous, y'all would have play of his in our community. Amen? So I heard, James Brown gay. I didn't believe that stuff. He's the biggest hole in out there. Amen? Amen? But they're passing that around because somebody in the business didn't like him because he superseded them. They probably out of jealousy put a lie out. Watch what people say about folk. Don't you become part of what somebody say. Amen? It says, I won't be before you long. I'm going to do a little teaching today. You don't mind. Amen? Cast out in every high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of God. That exalted itself. See, against the knowledge of God. See, Paul was dealing, he gave it a strong, he dealt with military metaphors. See, he dealt with military. Casting down imagination, exalting itself against the high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of God. Some things would exalt itself against the knowledge of God. Don't you become part of that mess. Don't you get become a part of somebody whispering something to you about somebody. This is the warning to help you. I don't know who this might come to, or it's going to be coming to you, or have came to you. It's just to help you. It's a warning. Lord, give me this today. It's a warning to you. It happens if you can kick yourself out of the position of your blessing. See, warfare is not like you think it is.
There you go, preacher.
Come on. Go back to the way this guy who was Darden, says certain military techniques he's going to use, another level of warfare he's going to use against the police, even their tactics and all that type of thing. You're in another level of warfare, and it's very subtle, okay? Very subtle in the spiritual realm. It's not like, I bang you, Satan, in the name of Jesus, da, 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 da. No. Satan, very subtle. If he can get you be part of undermining a work of God. Oh my God.
Yeah.
Undermining. See, these Jews were undermining They were resistance within. Majority was within, but that resistance was undermining, trying to come against Paul. Undermining. And Paul stepped up and said, I'm going to deal with you, bam. But I'm going to deal with you in gentleness and meekness. Don't force me. Amen? So, don't ever become a part of something to undermine once you discern that it's the word of God. Yeah. And so you're discerning first. And if you haven't discerned it's a work of God, don't let no one come to undermine you and get you to become a resistance, a force to have undermined a work of God. What happened is you start coming against God. And when you start coming against God, your arms are too short to box with God. And you wonder why you're going through the hell you're going through, unless it's a test, which has a beginning and end, or you're not receiving your blessings from God. Because you may have tapped into a lie, come in agreement with a lie, and who's the father of lies? Not knowing it. This teaching today is to help somebody. That for the future, all of you deal with it now. That he gave it to me this morning. I always wait and pray. I laid before him last night. He gave me this the other day. For somebody, a group of people, beware in the future. Don't be like those Jews that was coming against the apostle of God that had divine power and authority. Because God was the authority. They was coming against Paul. But actually, they was coming against God. And they don't have the power to deal with God. So he just gave me that teaching to give you as a warning to somebody in the future. Not even in this ministry, you go somewhere else in the future. This teaching is going to help you. Because when I speak prophetically. Amen. And a lot of people say the things I teach them, it comes like a nugget to them later on in life. This is impartation. Because later on, and I can be dead and gone, that the enemy will come at you this way. Because you'll be so close to your breakthrough. And the enemy will come in suddenly. Like a little snake. And it gets you just to think. And you think you're innocent. It's a little innocent thing. You come to agreement with that lie. Now here you going out against God, and you say you for God. And here that guy said, my people destroyed for the lack of knowledge, because he was ignorant. Ignorant of the devices of the enemy. Let's give the Lord a hand praise. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you. Give Lord a hand. Amen. Amen. Hope you learned something from that teaching through the Spirit. He gave me to give that to you today just to help you. Amen. So, you love music back there. If there's one who don't know Christ, if there's one who don't know Christ as their Lord and Savior, I present to you Christ, the Son of God, who came, went to the cross, laid his son and died over 2,000 years ago. But in the grave he came up on the third day with all power. Jesus the Christ, the Son of the living God. If there's one who don't know Christ, come. Today you hear my voice, heart, not your heart.
this one want to accept Christ, come and accept it today. Don't die without knowing Christ. Another problem? Just for the sign of three poems. Thank you, Lord, and pray. Special need? How many? A special need. Here we go. One person has a very special need. Okay. Praise the Lord. This time we're going to take your offerings and your tithes. And praise the God and bless it. Come in here. Let God bless you with. You guys receive something today. Not no shouting, not no hooting, hollering. It's impartation to your future.
And our answer, the word of agreement between heaven and earth is yes.
We're crazy. All things happen. All things happen.
Yes to you.
And we just thank you and pray for your father. Thank you, Jesus.
We say yes.
Say yes. Pray for your husband. I pray that God opens that door, Father, to close. That he be able to come and fulfill his purpose. And to remove for every situation, every situation. His future is hard, Father. Build up his faith in you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
We say yes.
Okay. I pray you got it by faith.
Thank you.
pressure is out of mind. Connect with God. Give our heart to God. Open our eyes. We will not be out of our way, Father. We stand in the presence of God. And in Jesus' name, amen. Blessings on the day we offer him, show him in a vision, open the mouth for him, show him the truth, say the things, keep your eyes safe for him, in Jesus' name, amen. Let it go. Father, in the name of Jesus, bless your eyes, bless your heart, 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 work with the great attitude, in the name of Jesus. I say, Lord, Christ in us, amen. Lord, Lord, work your thing out for me. If I work your thing out for me, it's good. You must get it, amen. Raise her up, leadership. Raise her up, Father. Oh, Quran, I come against everything of your past. Every hindrance force, every doubt, every fear. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I decree a blessing upon your life. Father, the next 7 days, bless your God. 7 days, I decree by faith a blessing in Jesus' name.
Will begin to move this
place. People are here. Even while I'm trying to hear, recording this. Praise God. Praise God. Come back again. Amen. Amen. Father, we just thank you. This ministry, look at me. There's a ministry in you. I'd like you to call me to find out with my secretaries. Thank you for calling. What's the name? Jenny, yeah. Give her my number or get their number. I did call you back. I did talk back to you. I don't know the number. I don't want to talk to you, but I want to see what you desire in ministry. I want to pray. Yeah. Okay.
Orchard, the mayor of the Quincy Church years ago, but just by receiving the presence of him, that's why I love the sensitivity of having the Lord when you worship, because that's the only thing that's been getting me healed and delivered. It's been a process. And you gave me a word today that much of the pain is going to be into power. And God does use me already, but it's been a long journey. It's been a hard one, but what I did is presence. So I'm coming here before I go to my, and I do want my pastor's minister. I do. But I feel like you guys are supposed to meet.
The anointing is here, Father. Raise your hands up. Father, he's going to use you more than you ever expected. He's going to use you.
I pray, Father, the prophetic and the healing. Shitty before Sunday. Now, Jesus. Oh, yes, Jesus. Come, come, come. Spirit is here. Thank you. I'd like you to bless this man of God. Everything from the past, back to the past. Take him to his future. In boldness, in Jesus' name, amen. God is going to use you. The devil wants you, but it can't happen. Your leadership, let me remind you, I'm in the Bible. You have to fight up. You get feistiness. This is the war of the spirit. You harness that and use it for the glory. Use it for the positive, not for the negative. It's a war of your knowledge. The fight of the spirit, man. You understand me? Or as far as I have the same kind of spirit, so I know. I have that fighting spirit. I'm not a turning into the spiritual power. Not natural power. You have to know how to harness it. Turn it to spiritual power in Jesus' name. Pray God's blessing upon you in Jesus' name, amen. Praise God. I pray God a hundredfold return blessing upon us. What kind of business do you do? Stand up. Home him. What position are you in? Coordinator, do you want to own? Hey, you haven't prayed about it yet?
Yes, I have.
You have prayed about the ownership?
Yes.
Come here. Father, in the name of Jesus. Hey, the Spirit is moving. Hey, shout out my cool son. Father, I just thank you and just praise you for the Son, Father. I thank you, Father. Oh, shady kasata. Turn that up, God, for the anointing. Lord, bless him now. Now, Lord, bless him. Shake it! Run this! Release it, Father. I'm praying on this. I have an entrepreneurial spirit. I have two corporations, like the Brown and International. But I can discern. I can discern people who are supposed to be in ownership. You know what I said? You have the leadership. It's a risk with the tip. Just be a water walker. Piss out of my super. We step out like Peter stepped out. God, stay the water. And that's how you have to be. Because it's in you. The leadership there, the training is there. You've seen, you understand the business. You understand how it works. You've seen the mechanics of it. God have allowed you into that. So you can have your own one day in time. Write the vision and make it plain. Write it on paper. Get the name. God will give you a name. I want to pray for it. I'm just typing out it. I want to pray for it. I want to pray for that vision. I love the reins of entrepreneurs to encourage them to be the head and not the tail of the boat. You can have people working for you. People working for you. You're a leader. Your queen. Raise your hand. Lord, I just release this anointing upon your daughter, Father. This entrepreneurial anointing, Father, that you release through my hands. Release it upon your daughter, Father. That she should have all that she desires. That she should have employees working for her. That she would be licensed. Certified by whatever entity she desires to have, Father. Open up that door, Father. Why is she open up the financial resources she needs for Shed Able Kosar?
Father, in the name of Jesus, release it upon your daughter. I speak wealth. Ooh, shede rosa. I speak wealth. Ishede rosa. Wealth. Ishede alabasa. Wealth. In neheseke. I speak wealth. Ifrandaba. I decree wealth upon your life. I decree wealth upon your life. I decree wealth upon your life this day. I picked up ownership. I didn't know you desired that. Who said they both saw that kind of write the vision, make it plain, put it on paper, bring it to me. Y'all hear me? Say, you come off the Father to make this best in the mighty name of Jesus. For the best of them. Best in the name of Jesus. If you got to read the best of them. In the name of Jesus. Praise God. I woke the time today. Can I see you? Father, in the name of Jesus, we bless. Father, in the name of Jesus, unite to a deeper level. Show them, open them. Show both of them, Father, something. Something, the same thing, Father. We show them the same thing, the purpose and destiny. In Jesus' name. Release it. I seal this unit with the blood of Jesus and the word of God. Jesus. You gotta come tonight? Tell people about tonight. You have not seen nothing yet without your ministry. Your heart is right before God for those people that God looks for people like you. This love of feeding people. I love to feed people. Oh, yes, I love my resources shall come. Doors shall be open. I want you to give me the name of that ministry on paper. Talk to me about it in detail. Jesus, we make sure you go for it. Let's back it up. I like that. Everything gonna be all right. 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 Jesus, bring him here. Thank you. Prosperity. That's your best man of God. Bless everything that's in touch. Open up those doors. In the business, in the vision. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hear us the next 7 days. Jesus' name. Father, in the name of Jesus, bless the young man, bless his finances, bless the Father, bless the increase, the increase. In Jesus' name. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Yeah. Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask you for favor. 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 Favor! I ask for favor, Father. Your servant needs the right transportation. She needs to move around. She's an evangelist, Father, so she got to move. So, Father, I ask you to move and make work out that car she needs, that transportation. It's not going to break down.
see the new places, new people, Father, ask for favor in this situation in Jesus' name. I just bless her husband, bless her ministry, bless her, Father, bless her. Jesus' name, amen. We praise you. Bless you. Bless her, Father. Bless her, Father. That he has for you, the devil can't block it, the devil can't stop it. You will keep you here. You don't fit. You just don't fit. We all here are misfits. Because we are children of God. God chose us. We only can fit in his spirit. We only can fit in his anointing. We only can fit in his power. We only can fit in his grace. We only can fit in his purpose. We only can fit in his destiny. Thank you, thank you. Thank you, Lord. I feel the Holy Ghost up in this place. You got it. Say, I got it. I got everything I said in the name of Jesus. I stand in agreement in the name of Jesus that he has it. He has the job. He has the car. He has the place. He's just agreeing to stand for blessings and finances. You got it! Receive it right now. Receive it! Receive it! Receive it. Don't lose it this time. Don't give it to the devil. It's from the Lord. Woo! You walk with me, you will be blessed. Be blessed tonight. I tell you, wait a minute, I don't get to understand this. Y'all can be blessed tonight. This man of God is internationally known. He's humbled himself to come down here to be a blessing to us. Be here, tell people about it. Get on the phone, get on your Twitter, your Facebook. Amen. Tell some women. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let's fill this house up. Y'all gonna fill the house up tonight?
Yes.
Y'all gonna fill this house up tonight?
Yes.
This is the real deal stepping up here tonight. Internationally known and renowned. Old warrior. He's going to impart to you something you'll be different when you leave here tonight. That's all I got to say. Raise your hands up. 6:30 doors be open. May the grace of God and the sweet command of this Holy Spirit rest with the divine here now and forevermore. We leave from this place but never from his presence. As the Lord go before us, but take us from all hurt and danger. I decree by faith to the people of God, bless going in, bless coming out. And blessings shall overtake us. In Jesus' name we pray. Hug your testimony, love of the Lord. God bless you, saints. In Jesus' name, amen.